back in the day, before we had to deal with virtual currency or shady community coordinators, there was a sports gaming studio that was for the people. 98.9 Sports was created in 1995 by Sony, and during the 90s and early 2000s, they were a powerhouse in the sports gaming genre. So today, we're just going to talk about them a little bit. With the launch of the PlayStation 1, also came the launch of NFL Game Day by 98.9 Sports. The game did so well that the following year, EA Sports also made a football game, Madden 97. Both games did well, with Game Day having a slight advantage almost every year. They followed up their success with retro bangers like NCAA Game Breaker, NBA Shootout, NHL Faceoff, and MLB 98. EA's response was to also put out bangers. They dropped Madden 97, NBA Live 97, NHL 97, and Triple Play 97. Now imagine if this was the time we were living in now, where we had two studios putting out great games with their intentions being to make the best game possible instead of trying to squeeze every penny out of us and in the process selling us out for Mountain Dew, Gatorade, and Reese's money. If 2K and EA would do what EA and 98.9 Sports were doing in the 90s, then basketball games right now as a whole, not even just basketball games, sports games as a whole, the sports gaming genre would be so much better than it is right now because Madden doesn't have any competition and 2K doesn't have any competition, so these guys are able to just put out whatever they want to put out. But if they were going neck and neck with every sports game that they put out like these two were, they would just push each other to get way better. So they continued to battle throughout the 90s and early 2000s. And at some point in this story, 2K Sports comes into the mix, but they're not important to this video. So come the year 2000, 98.9 Sports gets merged with a branch of Sony so they can get ready to get started on working on the games that are going to be dropping with the release of the PlayStation 2. This decision will prove to be their downfall after battling with EA for almost a decade. The launch of PlayStation 2 couldn't have gone worse for 98.9 Sports with all of their games, including their treasured football game and their treasured MLB game, both doing poor in their first PlayStation 2 games. Well, actually, Game Day 2004 wasn't terrible, it just wasn't properly optimized to play on the PlayStation 2. But this year was not the year for them to have a mediocre game. In 2003, EA Sports dropped Madden 04, and if you play Madden, then you know what Madden 04 did for Madden as a whole, for the Madden legend, for the legacy of Madden. Madden 2004 is very important. Madden 04 was so crucial that it forced 98.9 Sports to cancel their NFL Game Day game, they canceled their NBA Shootout game, and they also canceled their NCAA game, all of them as a whole. This is where it gets kind of interesting though, because around this time, they were actually getting better at making baseball games. Although the first one on PlayStation 2 wasn't great, the second one, MLB 05, they figured it out and they made a brilliant game. And they continued to make those games over the year, and that game, MLB The Show, that we all know now that we play on PlayStation, is literally that game. That's the game that 98.9 Sports made, and it's just still, they still make it. And they're also responsible for those NBA The Life games. So it's kind of cool if you think about it. In NBA 06 The Life, they created the My Career mode. Like, they had a story mode, a whole My Career where you just control only your player. And this was 2005, so they were way ahead of their time with the career mode. EA Sports and 2K wouldn't pick up on My Career until 2K10. And NBA Live didn't pick up on it until NBA Live 13. And it's wild to me because back in the early 2000s and 90s, EA were the new guys on the block who were hungry and on the come up trying to knock off the powerhouse. And now, like in this current day and age, they're the powerhouse who are trying to get back to their form, and they got knocked off by 2K. So it's like history is repeating itself. And now 2K is the big dog who's poised to get knocked off by somebody. But if only somebody would make a basketball game. Well, a good one. MLB The Show is the only game left over from the 98.9 Sports days, but I feel like they could still make a good football game and possibly a basketball game. I don't want to say they could make a good one because I wasn't really a fan of the NBA The Life games, but I know, bro, I feel like they could still make a good football game. But sadly, that's not a possibility because EA and Madden, they bought out the exclusive rights so nobody else can make NFL games. Isn't that great? And even though I said they are responsible for the NBA The Life games, I would like to see them throw their hat in the ring. Like, just somebody. It's better than nobody making an effort. If they made an effort and they failed, you know what? You lost some money, but you made an effort. That's all that counts, man, as long as you try. You feel me? So that's all I got for y'all today, man. What do y'all think? Do y'all guys remember 98.9 Sports and my old fart, the 22-year-old college student who's reminiscing on 98 non-sports games. Y'all niggas probably don't even remember 98 non-sports. But let me know what you think down in the comments, man. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. And as always, I'm D. Brown Shanahan, and I'm up out of here. All these people, heads are hollow, only want to be accepted, so they try to make an image to the soul is disconnected. To the day I stand corrected, I will fight with the viciousness. Years from now, you'll laugh because you witnessed this. Tell you why I spit like this, because I don't give a fuck. Way too many told me no until I felt like I was stuck, but I rose. So happy with the path that I chose. They call me Mariano because I'm bringing every game to a close now. They shoot.